Alright, so let's talk about my Canon EOS R5 photo experience. Intro. Okay, so the EOS R5 is a photo and video camera, and exactly that is why I bought the EOS R5, because I simply don't want to switch between a video and a photo camera. And yeah, that's why we need to talk about my photo experience using the EOS R5. So let's get started. So currently I use this camera all the time just to check out what kind of settings I like to use and how I can get the most out of the footage of the EOS R5. And of course this is not my final review here, but I try to share my overall experience with this camera so you will hear everything that I noticed while using this camera. And if you have watched my first impression video about the R5, you will know that I recorded a really basic photography session video taking some random pictures with the R5 and the EF70-200. And yet today I recorded another episode using the RF35mm. And there's a link down in the first comment, so if you're interested in that, definitely check that out. But what's about working with the R5? Well, I simply need to say that I love the overall workflow using the R5. The R5 is actually really easy to use, the menu is simple, and you can change all kind of buttons. So for example, my ISO settings are on the control ring. I can change the aperture by using the wheel right here, and I can switch the shutter speed by using this wheel. So I hope you see the Canon EOS R5 is actually really easy to use and I don't have to use the menu a lot, just for a couple of things. But now let's talk about taking photos, and here I need to say the camera is really fast. I mean, you just need to take a look at this.
And just to show you something, what way can you do this here? Let's switch to, where is it? The high speed continuous mode. And now let's see, let's give the focus. So, if you need to be fast, this one is the way to go.
And yes, sometimes you just want to get started to press the shutter button, and the R5 already took a couple of pictures. So especially if you need to capture some special moments like events or weddings, this camera will make the overall workflow way easier and you definitely won't miss any of these special moments because your camera is actually really fast. On top, this camera doesn't make a lot of noise, so especially if you're a photographer who needs to be quiet, for example, you won't have any problems. And yeah, I need to say that it surprised me a lot how they managed to reduce the overall shutter loudness. So if you don't want to get a lot of attention while taking photos, this is the way to go. But yeah, of course, we need to talk about the autofocus, and I really love the autofocus of the EOS R, and I don't had any problems at all. But the autofocus of the R5 is top-notch and super fast. For these recorded photo sessions, I mostly use the single dot focus point to make it easier for me to set up the focus while recording the footage, and yeah, as soon as I selected the area, the focus was on point. But sometimes when the key element was really small or thin and there was a lot of stuff in the background, the autofocus had some problems to find the key element. But here I simply used the manual focus to get in the direction and then I switched back to the AF, but actually that's something that can happen, especially if you take some macro photos of some small leaves, for example. And the eye autofocus of the Canon EOS R5 is really good too. I use it most of the time when I record these videos, and I use it in the photo mode too, so it was really good. But just to mention it here right now, I didn't have the chance to check it out while taking photos of some animals, but that's something I'll do really soon. So now let's talk about the editing, and currently there's a big downside if you want to edit your footage using Lightroom. A few people already know that, but I need to mention it here right again. If you want to edit your R5 RAW pictures in Lightroom, you currently can't import these files directly from your SD or CF Express card. And the basic reason for this is that Adobe simply don't support these files right now. But what they did is to update their DNG converter so you can use this additional app to convert your Canon RAW files into DNG files, and then you can import these new files into Lightroom. That's a little bit annoying, especially because you have to use another app to get your work done, but at least they made it possible that I can do something with all these files. But yeah, I hope Adobe will fix that problem really soon so we don't have to use a converter anymore. But now let's talk about my editing experience, and here I need to say that I love the footage of the R5. If you upgrade from the EOS R, you already know the overall process using these files, and I simply need to say that I don't have any problems to edit my R5 RAW pictures. The complete editing process to get the results that I want to have is super simple, and if you use these new RF lenses while taking these photos, the image quality is top notch. And especially if you do some client work, the R5 is a perfect camera to deliver some high quality content. And yeah, even if you use older EF glass like the 70-200 2.8 IS2, the quality is still awesome, and exactly that's why I like to use the R system. because I can use both mounts. So if you want to do the jump to the RF mount, you can still use your old EF glass until you can afford the new RF version, and that is extremely awesome. So yeah, all in all, I currently can say that the overall image quality of the R5 is just incredible. Currently, I would say the Canon EOS R5 is actually a really good camera for photography, and yeah, I simply don't want to miss it anymore. Especially if you're a professional photographer, this camera can pay itself off, so that's why I would recommend to go into your local camera store to check out the R5. But what do you think about the R5 so far? What kind of topic should I cover next? Let me know that in the comments. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new here, don't forget to smash that subscribe button to stay updated for upcoming videos, and I'll see you in the next video.